Start. Good morning, students. Today we will discuss about the construction features. Study the construction features of domestic refrigerator, those which were used in our house. So this is also known as the vapor compression refrigeration system. So in vapor compression system, so what do you know? What is vapor? So vapor is in the form of gaseous form. So which is having a gaseous form? That is the refrigerant. That is the refrigerant, and the refrigerant is having two contains or stay in a pipe. These two pipes you have seen, these two pipes, the refrigerant will flow through this pipe from different section of a vapor compression refrigeration system. First of all, this is the main part of a refrigeration system, that is the compressor. It have two valves, that is number one, that is the inlet valve or suction valve, another one is, that is the exhaust valve. So, and this is the some main part, also it is also known as the main part, that is the condenser, and this is the expansion valve, and this is the evaporator chamber. On this chamber, the evaporator coils are moved around it. So you can show what is the evaporator coils. These pipes, coils of pipes, they are rotated in a different way. They rotate in a way. So the refrigerant will rotate in this pipe. Okay? This is the evaporator chamber. In this chamber, the evaporator coils of arrangement is there. Okay? So first of all, what happens? Now in vapor compression refrigeration system, the refrigerant we are used. So earlier we have used R12 and ammonia also. Initially ammonia used, but in this system R134A is the refrigerant used in this system, which is already notified on there. So first of all, the refrigerant is drawn into the evaporator to the compressor through the inlet valve. This pipe you will see, this is the black covered pipe is the inlet pipe. On this pipe, the refrigerant will drawn from the evaporator to the compressor. And on compressor, the refrigerant will compress. After compressing, the pressure of the refrigerant will develop or increase the pressure as well as the temperature. The pressure increases and as well as the temperature also increases. After increasing the temperature and pressure of the refrigerant in form of vapor, it will pass to the condenser through the red color pipe which is showing in that color, red color. This is the exhaust valve or this on this exhaust pipe, and this is the exhaust valve and this is the exhaust pipe. On this pipe, the refrigerant in vapor form drawn into the condenser. So you know, we already know that the condenser is also having some number of coils of pipe. You can see on that way. You can see on that a number of coils of pipe there rotated on this refrigerant, and refrigerant is act as a cooler. Then the high pressure and temperature refrigerant is condensed or cooled on this condenser. On this condenser, the refrigerant is cooled or condenser. After cooling, what is? If we know that the stage of three stages of metal, that is solid, liquid and gas. If we develop or increase the temperature of a solid, it is going to liquid, and if again we increase the temperature of the liquid, it can become to gas or vapor. So if we cool the vapor, it can again back to liquid. Okay, so in vapor form, the high pressure and temperature vapor refrigerant and condenser is converted into liquid. Then, so normally in our figure there is a receiver and after passing through the condenser in liquid refrigerant after passing through the condenser can go to the receiver, and the receiver, the main purpose of the receiver is to receive or store the receiver store the liquid refrigerant and passes to expansion valve. So here you have seen the expansion valve. Here we have seen the expansion valve. That is, the expansion valve is also called the throttling valve. Also called the throttling valve or refrigerant control valve. Throttling valve or refrigerant control valve. The main function of the expansion valve is to allow the liquid refrigerant under high pressure and temperature. Allow the liquid refrigerant under high pressure and temperature to pass at a controlled rate, at a particular rate of flowing or passing to the evaporator. And after passing, before on that expansion valve, there is the liquid refrigerant is converted into vapor liquid mixture refrigerant. Mixture liquid vapor refrigerant. And some portion, greater portion is vaporized in the evaporator at low pressure and temperature. After that, the temperature and pressure also decrease at the evaporator. After going to the evaporator, evaporator also consists of coils of number of coils of pipe in which the liquid vapor refrigerant at low pressure temperature is evaporated. The liquid vapor mixes on there and passing to the evaporator, and on that evaporator the liquid vapor refrigerant is converted into fully vapor refrigerant. That means the liquid is evaporated, the liquid refrigerant is evaporated and converted into vapor. Again the cycles is running. Again the vapor refrigerant at low pressure and temperature is sucked to the compressor by the black coated pipe on that pipe, and again it develops the pressure and temperature and drawn into the condenser by the exhaust valve. The cycling process is continuously rotating, and we have to determine on there. We can study the main aim of vapor refrigerant, that is simple vapor compression refrigeration system. And we have to determine the COP, coefficient of performance, to find out the coefficient of performance to develop how many cooling capacity of the compression system is there. So that's all about the vapor compression refrigeration system, which is also known as the domestic refrigerator. Okay, thank you.